you have something called as attribute selector. What is the attribute selector? Selecting via presence of element attribute or by the value of an attribute. When you want to select by the value, if any attribute is there and that value need to be selected, then you are going to use attribute selector. The attribute selector is used to select elements with a specified attribute. Whichever specified attribute you are going to use, then you are going to use the attribute selector. The attribute selector provide a way to select HTML element by either the presence of element of attribute or by the value of attribute. So anything, two things will be there, either the element attribute will be there or either that value of the attribute, any two things will be there, then you are going to use the attribute selector. And this will be very powerful techniques because it support uneven support by the some of the browser. Not all the web authors have used them. Very few author will be using this, and it is the good techniques. And mostly now, whatever the browser you use, most of the browser is updated and it can be used in those browser also. The attribute selector can be a very helpful technique in styling of hyperlinks and images. When you want to hyperlink, in hyperlink what? You have some attribute, right? You have a value, that means you are giving the reference to some other page. You have image which is some outside, right? Or some other, that is the attribute. Okay, that is the value of attribute, or that is the element which you want to call. Then that moment in the CSS you are going to use as a attribute selector. How you will use attribute selector? The same way. The only the thing is that syntax is that whenever you want to use attribute selector, you have to use the big bracket symbol, opening and closing bracket symbol, bigger bracket. And you, between that you are going to define here as whatever the selector you want to define. So I am defining here as a title. In title we are using cursor, colon help, padding bottom we are telling 3 pixel, then padding border we are making bottom border 2 pixel with the dotted line and blue color. Text decoration will be nothing, none. This is the style sheet for the attribute selector. Now what we are going to do, we want to define this. Now what you have to do, when you are going to use as an image tag, as we mentioned, this will be useful for the image and hyperlink, right? So especially in the hyperlink. So what we have used here, we have used here image tag, some source image, okay, and we are giving the title as a Canada flag. So any flag name you can define. That how you can use. The same way that you can see in the second example, href countries.php id is equal to ca, we are specifying this attribute only should go to the ca. So this is php version. When we'll come to the php, then we'll get to know that. And some post, c post from Canada, so it will be given this information on that. Like that way, whenever you want to define a title, so see here I'm defining a title, different title is there, Canada flag at top of sulfur mountain, Grace, okay, Calgary downtown, different title is there, but we are using the CSS. That means it will give you like some small different symbol, and this style sheet will appear on this particular element. Let's see this, how it will be there. And we will use this in our code. We'll get to know that what will be the result. So you can use any code, whichever you want, it's up to you, but follow the same structure to use this one. It will be helpful. Let's see the